my company is named YoungWorks. We are specialized in communicating with youngsters. So at the age between a year of 10 and 25, we do all kinds of research. We do campaigns which is targeted at youth, and we dive into youth issues, youth trends all the time. And me myself, I work as a writer. I've written 3 books with a colleague of mine. Nowadays I give a lot of lectures and trainings for people who want to connect more with the young generation. Having had an academic education, maybe the most important thing I learned is that you become confident that you can dive into any field. You get analytical skills, that you are not afraid to dive into books and fields you don't know. For example, I published a book together with Huub Nelis about the teenage brain. Me myself, I'm not a brain scientist. I'm a social scientist, but I'm not afraid to take the journalistic view, like, let's get into this. How can I elaborate this into something that's interesting for a broad public? And I think that's something that drives me, and it's something that I'm really good at also.
Come on, clap, damn it, what's wrong with you?
For a long time we've been talking about emancipating girls, that they take their chances, that they take the best out of education. And the fascinating thing now is what you see at a university, but also at vocational education, that the girls, they do very well at school. They do very well at university, and they do better than boys. And for a while, people said, oh, that's incredible, the girls are doing so well. But I think there are interesting views to that. Because partly what we see, if we look at startups, for example, how many young women begin their own startup, it's a much smaller part than boys, for example. So I'm fascinated by that. The boys who relatively don't perform so well during their educational way, they sometimes they catch up and they get higher salaries, they get more into leading positions. And what I find shocking, if you look at the figures in the Netherlands, we still have a lot to do. So that's, I think, a very big issue. Personal branding, to me, I think it has to do with thinking about who you are, about what's important to you, but also to think which is a vital thing in communication. How do other people perceive me? And does that fit? Does that match the things I find important? Am I able to bring that to the public, to inspire people and to connect with them, like that somebody else says, yeah, that's your value, I find that very important too, or I find that funny, or I find that inspiring, to match, to connect. I think generally what I see at the young generation, they are very aware of how people perceive them, for example, in social media. How do I look? What do other people think about how do I look? Is that the impression I want to make? So that's an issue, this self-consciousness, which is partly, you could even say, too big. On the other hand, I think they often don't connect that with possibilities and chances that are ahead in the adult world, in the professional world, that they simply cannot perceive that it could be something for them. I could be an entrepreneur, or I could be a CEO, or I could be a team leader. I could be what I want to be if I take the steps day by day.